Do you want to increase the build quality of your kit 3D printer? Then stick around to see what you can 3D burn. I recently purchased a kit 3D printer from China, and I've put it all together and it's not bad. One of the issues that I'm having though is that the cables keep getting in the way, and I'm afraid that they're going to pull and actually rip out. So I did a little bit of research, and there's something that I can 3D print to actually make this work a bit better. It's called a cable chain or a cable carrier. Now, cable chains have been out since the 1950s, so it's nothing new, but for the 3D printing scene, it really helps. So what the cable chain is, it's a group of links that all link together, and once it's all together, it bends with the motion of, in this case, the X carriage. So I did a little bit of research and I went onto Thingiverse and they didn't have exactly the one that I wanted. I wanted mine to be about 2 centimeters on the inside diameter. So what I did is I pulled it into a program called Autodesk 123D Design and I made some modifications. And I'm going to show you how you can do that too. So I downloaded the file off of Thingiverse and you can find the link down in the description or if you go up to the little eye up in the top right hand corner. So this was the original file. And as you can see there, looks really nice. It's really nicely well made and they've even left in the original 2D sketch in case you wanted to modify that further. So the next step is to change the view to a top view. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're going to create a polyline, which will start there and finish there. I'll just press enter. Oh, I'll just hit exit mode. There we go. Okay, the next step we're going to do is we're going to split the solid. So we'll go up to here under the modify and go split solid. So the body we want to split is that one there. And then the splitting entity is the line and then press enter. Now we can safely pull that apart. So what I wanted to do now is I wanted to move that 20 millimeters. So zooming in, I can see there, if I rotate around, that split line is definitely in there. So first things first, just so I can see a little bit better, get rid of that. And I will also hide the sketches. That's better. What I need to do is I need to use the measuring tool. Measure from that point there to that point there. And that distance is 10 millimeters. So in knowing that, now what I want to do is select the whole object and I want to move that by a further 10 millimeters and press enter to confirm. Now we have 20 millimeters there, but I've got to extend these points across so that way they're touching. So okay, so what I've done is I've selected the top one, I'll select the bottom face as well, and we're going to use press pull. Pull that across by 10.5 just to be sure. Press enter. And now we have a 20 millimeter diameter gap in there that will fit the cables with the plugs on the end. Great. So now I can simply just go to save a copy to my computer. And that will save it as an STL file, which will print in just a second. Now, the footage that you're now seeing has been sped up, so that way you don't have to sit through it and get really bored. So this particular 3D print was printed using ABS plastic. What you're seeing is the ABS plastic being heated and melted onto the build plate, and it was printed using the Simplify 3D program. Simplify 3D isn't a free program, but I've got to say, it is worth every penny that I spent on it. And they've just recently upgraded to version 3, and the improvements are amazing. So if you do have a 3D printer and you don't mind spending a little bit of money on some quality software, then check out Simplify 3D. And here's the final product. So you can see that the cable chain does work. The only issue that I had is that prior to finishing this, my hot end actually broke. So I've upgraded to the E3D version 6, and I'm in the process of creating a new mount for that. So that will be in an upcoming video, but for now, I don't actually require this at this moment. So it looks great, but I can't really use it right now. So I'll have to put that one in the pile. Well, that's it for another episode of 3D Burn. I really hope you liked it. If you did, give me a big thumbs up and maybe even leave a comment down below. If you do enjoy the content that I'm providing, please make sure you subscribe to my channel because it really helps me a lot. And as always, imagine, learn, create. Bye.